Boom! What's up, gang? Jeff Bastien here, and welcome to another Studio Tuesday. So keeping your mix sessions organized is one of the best things you could ever do for your workflow, and it's also ridiculously simple to do. And if you're somebody who sends your mixes off to somebody else to be mixed, you definitely want to be doing this. Because if a mix engineer opens up your session and finds 90 tracks of Untitled 1, Untitled 2, Untitled 3, he's probably going to come to your house and beat you with an angry trout. And really, who wants to be beaten with an angry fish? So as usual, what I'm going to show you today is going to be applicable in any DAW. How to do these things might differ a little bit, but either way, you should be able to do them. So with that said, let's dive into Logic. Alright, so this is going to be short and sweet because it's that simple. I'm also prepping this session for an upcoming video on mixing, so that's why everything's zeroed out and there's no plugins or anything on it, so just pay no attention to that. First thing you want to do is group all of your different instruments together. So if you see here, I've got my drums, and then that comes down to my basses, and then that comes down to the guitars, then that comes down to a piano, some synths, and then the rest of it's all vocals. Now you'll need to come up with a system that works for you, but as an example, I always organize my drums in a specific way. So I always start off with the kick, snare top, snare bottom, then going from the smallest tom to the largest tom, the hi-hats, overheads, and then the room mics. This is something I do every time, always, without fail. So that's the first part of it, is just grouping same instruments together. Second part is just naming each track. As I'm sure you've noticed by now, everything in here is named. There's no track one, track two, track three to get lost in. It takes half a second, just name your tracks. So on top of naming your tracks, you can actually add little icons to each track that'll also help you further organize your session. So in Logic, that would be this little section right here, the inspector. Now, if you don't see this section here, all you have to do is click this little inspector button, and that'll hide and reveal the inspector, or you can just hit I on your keyboard, it'll do the same thing. And with that open up, just click the little disclosure triangle for the track, and then you can click on the icon here, and this will open up, and there's all sorts of icons that you can pick from. Just pick one, and it'll assign it to that track. So if you're starting a new session, the way you would want to do this is to start coloring at the mixer. So you just hit X on your keyboard, and that would pull up the mixer. Select the tracks that you want to have be a specific color, and then just hit Option C on your keyboard, and that'll pull up the color palette. You can also go to View, and it'll say Show Colors. Just click on that, and then just pick a color, and you'll see it's changed down on the mixer. I'm going to put that back to the color I like. Another way you can do this is you can just highlight the specific regions you want to color. Same thing, Option C, and then you can change the color that way as well. Next way to organize your session is by having markers set up for the different sections of the song. So as you can see here, we got intro, verse, chorus, second verse, chorus, so on and so forth. So the way to do this is make sure this little button is lit up blue, and that's going to give you your marker view. Now if you right click or control click on this, this is going to give you a little dialog box so you can show different sections if you want. But for this, all we need is the marker view. And then to make a marker, we're going to take our cycle region. Let's drag this over here. And there's nothing here, so I'm going to drag this down, and it's going to make a new marker. We're going to call this pre-roll. Hit enter. You've got a marker. And just like everything else, we can color them. So again, just hit Option C on the keyboard. Let's make this one purple. Deselect it. You can see it's purple. And if you need to resize the marker, if you hover over the marker and then you get right to here, you'll see that little icon changes. Just drag around that. You can do that on either side. That way you can resize the marker if you need to. Now you can see all my chorus markers are red, so if we want to change those all, you can just hold down the Shift key and click on each one. That'll select those three. And again, Option C again, and we can make those a completely different color. Another cool thing that we can do with markers is we can add notes to each specific marker. So the way you would do that is just select a marker and hit D on your keyboard, and that's going to bring up the list view. If it defaults to event, just click the marker, and then you can click down in this area, and you can start adding notes. And then just click out of there when you're done. And if you want to be able to see the notes without having to go back into the list editor, just come over here and you can drag this down and you can see your notes. So another area in Logic where you can actually make notes is in the track mixer on the individual tracks itself. So to do that, just hit X and then go to View here and then go to Channel Strip Components. And there's a whole bunch of stuff that you can turn on and off. And at the bottom, you'll see notes. So if you click on notes, you see down here, now notes pop up. And I left one earlier that says your bass sucks, feed them to the Sharktacons. But to add other notes, just double click in that note area. Boom, Bob's your uncle. And while we're here on the mixer view, if you remember earlier, I said that I lay my tracks in a specific order. I do drums, then bass, then guitar, and so on and so forth. Well, in your mixer, you want to do the same thing with your buses. So if we scroll over to my buses over here, you'll see they're laid out in the exact same order. Drums, bass, guitar, synths, vocals. Now the last way to help organize your session is to use folder stacks or summing stacks. Now in Logic, folder stacks and summing stacks are basically the same thing, but in some ways not, but I'll get into that in another video. But all you have to do is select the tracks that you want to put into a stack, select them all, hit Command-Shift-D on your keyboard, and this little dialog box will open up, and you can just hit Create, and it's going to put them all into a stack here. So now you would name this, give it a fun little icon, and as always, color it, match the drums, and there you go. Now, if you want to see the whole drum kit, just open and close this little disclosure triangle. You can show and hide your drums to help clean up your session. And there you go. There's a whole bunch of different ways to help organize your sessions. I don't even know how many. I think I stopped counting after two. But add up all those little tips I showed you, and it'll make your life a hell of a lot easier. And you won't have to worry about a mix engineer coming to your house and beating you with an angry trout. So that's it for today. So don't forget to like, subscribe, ninja kick the bell button. I'll see you guys in the next video.